As we know, a computer is not limited to handling numbers, but it can handle other types of data, for instance, text. Now, if we look at it at a very low level, though, the memory of the computer can only store ones and zeros represented by voltages on the pins of the CPU. So, how is a computer going to distinguish between something like the number 2, which is an integer, and this number 3.5, which is actually a real number, decimal number, called normally floating point number, or for instance a low word that, as we have seen, is a character string? Now, the programming language does that, keeps track of that distinction for us through the concept of data type. A data type, if you want, specifies how the data that is in the memory in terms of ones and zeros is actually to be interpreted, whether it represents a sequence of letters or it represents a decimal number. And the internal representation, if you click on this link, you will see it can be pretty complicated. But in the end, the way this is presented to us is relatively straightforward. So we identify the type to Python just by writing down the data in one way rather than in another. So for instance, if I write 3.5, I'm specifying that this is a decimal number just because it is. If I write 2, well, that is that number is an integer. But if I write 2.0, then I mean that is a decimal number, of which the decimal part is 0, but that should be represented internally as a decimal number. And if I write hello world in double quotes, then I mean that is a character string. For instance, it is not the name of a variable. By the way, name of a variable could not contain spaces, but you see, when I'm writing mass here, this is the name of a variable because it's outside quotes, but hello world is within quotes, and so it is a string. Incidentally, you can use single quotes to delimit a string, and you can also use triple quotes, in which case the string can be on multiple lines. Just as numbers, strings can be assigned to variables, and if we print the value of this variable, that's going to be the string. Now, just in case you wonder why Python gives you this flexibility in defining the string, you can actually choose your type of quotes. One of the reasons is this. Imagine that you want to print a string that looks like this. I'm Monty. Well, this is not going to work because actually Python will interpret the string as starting here and finishing here and containing only the character I, and then obviously doesn't know how to make sense of the rest. So in this case, for instance, you're obliged to write something like that, and this will work. Vice versa, should the string contain double quotes, you would have to start it and finish it with a single quote. It's worth going through these examples in some detail because the concept of data type influences what you can do with the value and what operators you can apply to it and what those operators do to your value. So for instance, have a look at these two examples, and here we have the plus sign, which is the same, but it means something for integers and it means something completely different for strings. So in the case of integers, it means the sum, that as we expect. In the case of strings, it means concatenation. So essentially, it will join the two strings. If you look at this case, this is multiplication. But if you try to multiply a string by an integer, what Python does is it creates n copies according to this number of that string and concatenates them. So the result here is ho, ho, ho. But obviously, not all operators can be applied to all data types. So for instance, exponentiation wouldn't work here. You cannot compute the third power of a string, and that would be an error. Python will tell you type error, unsupported operand types for power, string, and integer. So I can't compute the third power of a string. That's what it's telling you. But equally, you may be surprised to see this actually. See, so we said this works. See what happens if actually I write this as 3.0. Again, I get an error. I can't multiply sequence by a non-integer of type float. So this is the sequence it's talking about. And you cannot multiply a string by a non-integer. Why? Because if I start using a float here, actually I could be writing something like that, and then I am in trouble. How am I going to compute the 3.3 multiple of a string? Therefore, data types and operators interact in a complex way. But I think here we can all see that these are two strings, and so that case is different from the sum of two numbers. But if you look at this example carefully, you should find it at least a bit surprising. So here I have two lines, and this is actually, they're twice the same line, print A plus B. But what they do is profoundly different. So this line of code computes the sum of two numbers, and this line computes the concatenation of two strings. Which means that this plus operation is not the same in the two cases, although I'm writing it in exactly the same way. So how does the interpreter know which operator should be applied? And again, this comes down to data types. So in other languages, this would be more obvious because, for instance, in Java, you would be obliged to write, if you have a numeric variable, to write that, for instance, it is an integer, to declare it as an integer. And if you have a string, you'd be obliged to write down that it is a string before you can even assign a value to that. In Python, you're not obliged to do that. However, each variable does know its type. In general, a Python variable infers what type you want it to be from the value that you assign to it. So for instance, if I write a equal to, I would assume that it is an integer variable. If I write a equal 2.0, then a will be a floating point variable. And if I assign a string to it, it will be a string. And the type function allows you to know in each case the type of a, which is the type of the value that you've stored into a. So in general, you can trust Python to do the right thing and to pick the right type with your data and to behave coherently. There are a few pitfalls that we will encounter later on, but by and large, it's a system that imposes minimal overhead on you, but that still makes sure that only operations that are legal for the data type and coherent and meaningful get carried out.